a dream that my poor little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character.
If you're black and you say to me, you're acting white, what is it you're saying about black people?
I've often wondered why in a society so advanced in technology and infrastructure that we can still resort to the simple-minded thought of racism. I wondered if it was truly just heritage, as many people claim, or that people really don't mean to judge, but that it was their clothing that somehow set them apart and not their skin color. Being raised in a home where your self-worth came from within and your responsibilities and how you handled them meant more than what you look like, I could never understand why someone was automatically judged by the color of their skin. So I set out on my small campus to find out why racism still exists.
Yes, racism does exist about me.
So if we're all a part of the human race, what is racism? And why does it exist?
Hating on somebody for a reason like color or where they come from, I guess.
Discrimination.
Small-minded people.
I think it's because, well, for the people who I am around, it's mainly because how they've been treated by people in the past.
To me, race is just a physical trait about yourself. Just color, really.
People aren't going to actually say, yeah, I'm a racist, but when it comes to, like, you know, school activities, okay, he can shoot a basketball, okay, he can throw a football simply because he's on the football team, but certainly it does exist.
I think it's because there's so many different places that racism exists. People just, like, tend to group together, basically, or, like, if you don't understand someone else or what that other culture is used to or what they do, then you just don't understand it. You tend to stay away from it, kind of.
Listen to him, Louise. That's what happens when you mix black and white. 10 more seconds, he's gonna call her nigga.
In addition to that, I ain't used that word in 3 years.
Like, the main difference with it is just like how, like, one culture says it. You know, with a black person, though, they don't say, like, the full, you know, ER. You know, it's kind of like a slang term, but as you know, like a different way for a white person these days pronounce it correctly. And I guess it's still, if we hear it from a person that we're not like cool with or something like that, or a white person, it just feels like derogatory. Just because somebody else says it doesn't mean anything.
I think it's different, but I still don't think black people need to say it as much as they do, like use another word or just, I don't know, it doesn't sound good. Like, intelligent, or you just don't need to say it.
Racism never gonna go anywhere.
Every person, I can sit here and say all day that I'm not a racist, but there's gonna be that part of you that is. It's never gonna go away.
This borders in our minds so that we say he's different and we don't see ourselves as one race.
People see it as this gigantic difference between everybody else. And as long as we have differences, like whether physical or mental or belief-wise, we're going to have people thinking that their difference is superior to their difference, or that kind of thing.
People just don't take the time to understand people as individuals rather than grouping them together, so it's just always going to be that way.
Well, I'm not different. My skin color is just probably different from yours. I still have problems. I still know how to have fun and be happy, whatever. Yeah.